So continuing on with this discussion we're having about string methods, we've looked at the char at method, which again belongs to the sentence, and the sentence is a string. But there are lots of other things we can do once we have some text. So I'm going to go ahead and back out this. I'll take all this out and just look at some other things we can do. So I can still use sentence. And we can say, I've made a huge, I've made a huge mistake. Okay, so there's our sentence we've got. Now, what if I want to go in and actually get parts of that? As we look at the different methods that are available to us in the string, there's lots of different things we can do. And by the way, one of those things is equals. Right? We will compare the string, and then we have equals ignore case to be able to compare the contents of one string object to another. But we have lots of different methods available to us. So I can go in and get a substring. I can go find, for example, the first space. And then with that first space, I can figure out to be able to get, like, let's say I wanted to get the second word out of this sentence. So I've made a huge mistake. I want to get made out of there. Well, I can do that by using a combination of methods. First of all, I have to find out where the space is. Well, I need the char at method to go through and... Actually, no, I don't. I can use something else. always kind of fun in the middle of these videos when I discover something. I just remembered in my brain that we can get an index of a particular character. So we can tell us... Notice index of will give us the return... or will return the index within the string of the first occurrence of a specified character. And this is just one version of index of where we pass it a char. And then there's another version where we can pass it a char and the from index, so we can give it a starting character. And so if I want to strip this out in, and I want to get the second word, I can go, first of all, say, give me the index of the space. So now that I have my sentence, I can say, go out to that sentence and give me the index of, and then what I'll pass it is a space. Okay. Now if I were to print this out, oh, I guess I probably ought to have a variable to hold this. So I'm going to create an integer variable and call it first space, and set it equal to 0 to begin with. And then I'm going to set the first space equal to the sentence.index of. Now, if I'd just done what I was going to do in the first place, the program would have run and it wouldn't have done anything because I'm getting that space, but I'm not setting it anywhere. Now I'm storing that in the first space variable. So then I say system.out.println. And I'm going to print now what's in the first space variable that I've created so I can see where is the first space located and make sure it's right. It's telling me it's at position 4, okay? 1, 2, 3, well, we got to start at 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that's right, okay? So once I have that, I can go in and get the next word to the space, but I need to figure out where the second space is, probably. Unless I can, and something else comes to me here. Because we can go in and get a substring. We can say, give us a beginning index and an end index. So if I use the substring and start it at position 4, it'll give me the new substring to the end of the sentence. But if I only want to get one word, I guess I'm probably going to need to figure out how to get that second space. All right, and even though I've messed with this before, I'm having trouble remembering exactly what is available to us. So I'm just kind of looking through the methods, saying, what could I use here? What tool can I use? Well, I think probably what we'll want to do is find the next space, and we can do that by using the index of and then starting at the position, and it starts the search at the specified index. So what I probably want to do is go in and find the second space, So I'll create a second variable, and I'll say after you've gotten the first space, then I want to set the second space equal to what? Now, I hope this is a like a teacher's dream here, is that you, instead of just waiting, watching what I do, are going to pause this video and say, now how would I do this? And then check to see if I do the same thing, or maybe you come up with a better way. And that's totally reasonable to think of, that might happen. So we say second space, and we can then say second space equals sentence.index of, I'm still looking for a space, but this second option allows me to put in a starting place. Well, I want to go past the first space, so I'm going to grab whatever the first space is. Now, I think if I do this, I'm still going to get a 4. Let's test it and see. So I'm going to print out system.out.println second space. Because what's giving me that hint is it says that this version, starting the search at the specified index. So it'll look for a space at position 4 first, and my guess is it'll both be 4, and that's right. Okay, so both of them are 4. So I don't want to start there. I want to start at first space plus 1. So let's go to index 5 in this case. And now it tells me the second space is at 9. So I got the first space at 4, the second space at 9. Well, now I want to get this string. So I'm going to create another variable called string second word. Why I would be looking for the second word, I don't. Quit giving me a hard time about this. It's hard enough to come up with these examples. I don't know why we're doing this particular example. I don't know where this would be useful, but hopefully, I know the index of and the char at and all these are very useful. Well, now I want to go in and pull out a substring. So a string is just substring is just a piece of a string, right? So I look at my substring methods, and I can give an int. I'll actually click on it and go into the detail. This returns a new string that is a substring of this string. The substring begins at the specified begin index and extends to the character at the index end index minus 1. So it's going to be one less. So we start at whatever character we start at. If I'm interpreting this, the beginning index is inclusive. The ending index is exclusive. So that tells me that I want to start not at position 4, but at position 5, and I do want to go to position 9 because it's not going to include the last character, but the first character does include. Let's test it out and see if I'm up in the night here. So the second word is going to be equal to sentence dot substring, and I'm going to pass it now two pieces of information, an integer for the beginning index and an integer for the end index. So I'm going to pass it for first space plus 1 as my beginning index, and I'm going to pass it second space as my ending index. Let's see. Oh, I gotta do something with it, I guess. System.out.println. Let's see if our magic worked here. So the second word is, and then the second word. I'm just picturing that this is like going to be the next bestseller app. You type in a sentence, I'll give you the second word of that sentence. This is not highly impressive stuff. But let's see if it worked. Okay, we probably ought to put it in quotes. So remember, I can't just add a quote in there, or that'll tie off my string and mess everything up. But I need, if I'm going to print something, I need to do a backslash quote, and that will print the quote. And then if I want another quote, I have to concatenate that on after the fact. So I'm going to concatenate on a backslash quote and then a quote to end that string. Okay, so I've got my first quote here and my second quote here, and then I've got second word in between them. And there we go. The second word is made. And I probably ought to put a period or something on that end of that sentence. Okay, is this not impressive? Is this not cool stuff? So we've done this by using the pre-built methods that come along with the string. We use the indexOf method to find the first space, and then once we had that, then we used another version of the indexOf method that uses two parameters. We're looking for a space still, but we started our search after that first space. Once we had those two numbers, which we were printing out, then we go use the substring method of the sentence to go get at beginning at the first space plus one and ending at the second space, and we're going and getting that substring out of the string and storing that in our second word variable, and then we print out whatever that second word is. And now that this is set up, it should just use whatever sentence we put in there, right? So if I take this sentence out, and then I put something like no touching, well, then I get an error because there is no second space. This is a horrible example. Why did I use that sentence? I'm trying to stay in the theme here that some people are going, why is he using these phrases? That makes no sense. I've made a huge mistake. No touching. Okay, let me think of another one real quick. How about it's the final countdown? This should give us the. Okay, so the second word is the. Isn't that cool? I mean, we can go in and put any sentence in and pull out the second word based on this string manipulation. So just maybe to wrap up this idea of strings and string manipulation, if we look at those methods that we have available to us, I'll just talk through a few of them that are really kind of useful. One is, down here at the bottom, is trim. Trim is something where it will strip out the white space on either end of the string. So leading and trailing white space is omitted. This is good to make sure there didn't get to be any extra spaces in there. So we can trim, and the way we would do that is to say sentence.trim, right? Or whatever the name of the string is, .trim. And that would remove all the white space. We'd have to set it equal to something, so I'm not doing a very good job of explaining this, but it would have to be, something like this. In fact, we can do it. We could say the sentence is equal to sentence.trim. And that goes and takes off any white space at the beginning, any white space at the end. It leaves the white space in the middle because we need that, right? But then if there's any extra spaces, then it strips it off. So that's one that I've used fairly often in my experience, I guess, my programming experience. We can make stuff too uppercase. So we can make this sentence too uppercase after we've done this. We can take second word and say, make second word equal to whatever second word was dot to uppercase. And if we do that, then we get all capital letters for result. There's a two lowercase. Substrings we talked about. There's splits for regular expressions. We're not going to get into that in this lecture, but that's something that we can use quite regularly. The index ofs. And so there's a lot of different things. So go in and explore and try and figure out how these things would be useful. And then when you run into a problem where you need to do something with the string, then let's look at the string class and see what's available to us before we go out and try and write our own thing, right? Oh, contains. Does it contain a specific sequence of chars in there? So anyway, that is string methods, and there are a lot of them, and they are really helpful in my experience in programming to try and get what you need out of the strings. Okay? All right. Spencer out.